वंदे मातरम। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू टू माय चैनल कोर्टरूम बैटल्स। माय नेम इज डॉक्टर तुषार मंडलेकर। आई एम प्रैक्टिसिंग लॉयर इन बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट सिंस लास्ट वन डिकेड। आई डिड माय पीएचडी इन लॉ एंड आई यूज्ड टू टीच लॉ इन नागपुर यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम अ सोशियो लीगल एक्टिविस्ट एंड लॉयर, मेनली प्रैक्टिसिंग इन सिविल साइड इन बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट। It's my pleasure to introduce you to this new channel named as Courtroom Battles. If you are a student of law, if you wish to be a lawyer or interested in enjoying any kind of things including judgments and the courtroom battles, you are welcome to my channel. Please come and enjoy this beautiful journey of evolution of law in India. I'll be happy to answer your queries if you give your comments in the section. Please subscribe to my channel, share it, and enjoy this channel, Courtroom Battles. Hello friends, welcome back again to my channel, Courtroom Battles. We are into second part of the career opportunities after law. Let's see what are the options available to an aspiring lawyer when he just passes out of the law college. Now, each one of you must have imagined to make huge money into the law career. That's fine. That is what the dream of every lawyer is. And you are absolutely right. You can make huge money into this profession. This is the only profession which will give you unlimited money. Now, once you come into the practice, you have to become a practicing lawyer to get huge money. I'll be explaining you what are the career options in this video. Please keep on watching. So, career options in law. This is something which is required to be considered by every aspiring lawyer. Now, two parts which are required to be seen here is one, litigation lawyer and non-litigation lawyer. Once you decide yourself that you will be the practicing lawyer, then make sure sky is the limit, my friends. You can make tons of money. There are top-notch lawyers in this country who have worked rigorously hard for their success. So top successful lawyers, mind well dear friends, they make huge money. You cannot even imagine. So non-litigating lawyers cannot make such a huge amount of money. Now what kind of money they can make? Can you imagine? A lawyer practicing in Supreme Court of India, can he make 1 crore a day? Yes, you have heard me right. So there are lawyers who are making around 50 crores every year, my dear friends. So that is what the exact amount you can also earn if you decide to be a good litigating lawyer. Now, who are these big shot lawyers? You all know about them. Let me tell you. List of these top lawyers is not that big. There could be hardly 20 or 25 lawyers who make this kind of money. But who doesn't like money? For the purpose of getting such a huge income, you will have to work very hard. You will have to work at least for 30 long years to get this kind of level. Obviously, you must have that metal into you. Now, who are these lawyers? Let's talk about that. Harish Salve. We all know he is one of the biggest lawyers in this country and who has fought India's case in International Court of Justice. It is being told that for 3 to 4 months he is also practicing in Britain. He was Solicitor General of India. Mukul Rohatgi. He was Attorney General of India. He is a big name in Supreme Court. Fali Nariman. The man himself, who is a giant and legend, he has been bestowed with the Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan in this country, and his illustrious son is a Supreme Court judge now. K.K. Venugopal, who is Attorney General of India, he also has received Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. Gopal Subramanian, who was Solicitor General of India. Kapil Sibal, we all know, he was a minister in Congress regime. P. Chidambaram, He was also a minister in Congress regime. Dr. Abhishek Singhvi. He did his PhD. And one of the youngest senior counsels, an additional solicitor general in India. He's a Congress spokesman. C.A. Sundaram, who fought for BCCI. And a very senior name. Salman Khurshid, who was also minister in the Congress regime. K.T.S. Tulsi, who is a sitting member of parliament. Soli Sorabji, the legend in himself. He has also been bestowed Padma Bhushan, who was Attorney General of India. Then Ram Jethmalani, who has just passed away. He was also a minister. K. Parsaran, he is also a legend in this field. He has spent 60 years and he has also been bestowed with Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. Dr. Rajiv Dhawan, he also fought big names, including the Ram Janmabhoomi case. Then, Shanti Bhushan, who was a law minister in this country. And Raju Ramchandran. Mind well, friends, all these big players, they have spent their entire life into the judicial process. Many of them have spent 60 years in Supreme Court. So each one of these lawyers have spent their entire life into the courtrooms. They are warriors of court and they have knowledge, enormous knowledge. So the money doesn't fall on the very first day, my dear friends. But if you are dreaming high for the money and a lucrative financial practice, you are right. You are into the right profession. Please join the law and make yourself as a litigation lawyer. So, first proposition is the opportunity which you will get in courtrooms will pay you. So, you have to invest. This is the only profession which doesn't require money to be invested. It requires your knowledge. Once you begin with your knowledge, you can always reach the pinnacle of height and the success will be yours. The only situation is you will have to work very hard for the longer duration. Because in practice, you doesn't get money in the very first year. So the tree of experience will have to be now inculcated. The fruits will come after some years. But make sure you work very hard. So the first option after the law college would be the practice. If you come in practice, if you have the mettle to argue, if you are hardworking, please come and join the practice, for which you will need a guru. So please join a chamber of a senior who will teach you. So the opportunity in law field is welcoming you. It is only for you, provided you decide to walk on a path. Make sure you succeed in your endeavors, when you plan your career accordingly. So in order to start your practice, dear friends, you will have to obtain a sanad. Advocates Act 1961. This is the act which governs the conduct of the advocates. So after passing out from the law college, you will have to apply to the state bar council and get your sanad. That sanad is a license to practice. But where can you practice? Depending upon your area of interest, you can always choose your courts. Apart from constitutional courts like Supreme Court and High Court, you also have 25 tribunals in this country. So you have 25 tribunals wherein you can practice depending upon your area of interest. We have industrial tribunals. We have income tax tribunals. We have customs and excise tribunals. We have appellate tribunals. We have service tribunals like CAT and MAT. Then we have railway tribunals. Then we have securities appellate tribunal for the share market. Then we have National Commission for Consumer Disputes. Then we have electricity appellate tribunals. So on and so forth, we have 25 tribunals. Please watch my another video which we have explained about the 25 tribunals in this country. So in practice, dear friends, apart from constitutional courts, you have 25 tribunals. You can nurture your area and you can go and practice in all these tribunals. Secondly, you also have opportunity to appear before statutory authorities or quasi judicial authorities where statutory appeals are being decided in particular acts. Like mostly in acts, there are appeals with the quasi judicial authorities where you can appear. So appearance can be done in any of these forums. So there are no dearth of opportunities for you if you decide to come into practice. Now, second area of interest would be non-litigating side. If you decide not to enter courtroom, but still you are a lawyer, so you can have the second choice, that is non-litigating side. Now, who are those lawyers who will be into non-litigating side? Those lawyers who are working from the back-end office. They can join law firms. They can assist the senior counsels. You can go into research mode. If you are a good researcher, you have an option to become a researcher. If you are into good drafting skills, so you can draft very well. So opportunities for non-litigating lawyers are also big, and many of the companies, they require such kind of lawyers. Now, apart from this, you also need to get jobs. So you are entitled to get the job. You can be a law officer in any of the government, or you can be a law officer into private sector offices, banks, cooperative banks, or the corporate offices. There are posts which are coming up every year. So you can always be a law officer in all these fields. So jobs can also be an option after the law. The non-litigating side is also very powerful and is equally paying. If you decide to be a non-litigating lawyer, then you should be very good at your knowledge and specialize yourself into a particular field. If you are good at the company law, there are a number of lawyers who are required and being hired by the companies for different kind of purposes. There are several contracts which are required to be signed by the business entities. There are mergers, there are acquisitions, there are amalgamations, there are foreign mergers, and there are international contracts also. So if you are good into company law, you can have a very lucrative non-litigating practice in company law. The second option of a non-litigating lawyer would be real estate. There are lawyers who are working day and day night for the real estate sector. When they are doing convincing deeds, there are agreements to sell, there are sale deeds, there are will deeds, relinquishment deeds, several things which are required to be done. If you are good at drafting, then you can always join this field, which is also very lucrative. Thirdly, we have seen that whenever the banks are giving their financial assistance, there is a necessity of research report. So you can become a research report lawyer. You can search the property, get your report, and give it to the banks. On the basis of your research report, the finances are being given. So this is one of the options for a non-litigating lawyer. So you can become a government leader also. This is a third stream. If you want to be a government lawyer, there is always a chance. If you begin with the smaller courts, there is an APP post, Assistant Public Prosecutor. And PSC exams are being conducted in every state every year for the APP post. So you can be Assistant Public Prosecutor in a smaller court. Then you can be Assistant Government Pleader if you go to the district court or criminal court or into high court. There is a post called as Assistant Government Pleader. Apart from that, there are two more posts. It is Additional Government Pleader and the Government Pleader. So these are hierarchies of government lawyers. Government pleader will have to report to his bosses or to coordinate with the Mantralaya officials to represent the government side into the High Court. Then we have Assistant Solicitor General and Solicitor General of India. These are very coveted and dignified posts. And the top post in India is Attorney General of India. So you have an option to be a government lawyer. And mind well, there are opportunities to get yourself elevated as a High Court judge from the government lawyer's side. Apart from private practice and government practice and getting yourself into the job of corporate world, there is a coveted post of a judge. So you can join judiciary. In India, the moment you pass out from a law school, there is an option to become a JMFC judge. The only criteria is you will have to clear the PSC exam. In every state, there are posts for the junior level judges. So you can begin your career as a JMFC judge. After 6th and 7th pay, these junior level judges are also getting handsome pay packages. A junior level judge, once joins, can be promoted up to the sessions judge, district judge, and thereafter 15 years, he can also be into the High Court. So there is an option of getting yourself elevated as a judge of the High Court once you join the lower level or the subordinate judiciary. You can directly also become additional district judge if you have a 7 years experience. There is another examination of MPSC. According to seniority, a person becomes a district judge, and among the district judge, when he becomes senior and he is found fit, then he is selected as a High Court judge. Secondly, you can directly become a High Court judge if you have number of experience. As per the Constitution of India, any lawyer who is practicing in India having 10 years of experience can be elevated or appointed as a High Court judge. So there is a collegium system in India where the judges themselves select the judges. So you can always have an option to get elevated yourself from the subordinate judiciary as a High Court judge, or from the bar, from the practice of the lawyers, so you can be elevated as a High Court judge. And if you become a senior most judge of the High Court, you become a Chief Justice of the High Court, and later on there is an opportunity to get the highest coveted post, that is the Supreme Court judge. So this is an hierarchy where you can be elevated or appointed as a judge. This is a good career option into a law field to become a judge. Another option which is available in law field is academics. If you believe that practicing in courtroom is not your cup of tea, or you do not want to join any company and do not wish to become a servant, then you can consider yourself as a good academician. After law, you can do the postgraduate, that is master's in law. You can also choose to be a research scholar, get your PhD. And there are two exams, NET and SET, National Eligibility Test. So once you pass NET and SET, you are eligible to become assistant lecturer in any of the law colleges. So you can teach law if you have the mettle of teaching law. You have an inclination to become a teacher. So you can be assistant lecturer in law college. Then you can elevate yourself as a professor, reader, head of the department, and also become vice chancellor someday. So area of academics is also very important, and it is also good paying. Mind well, salaries of the professors nowadays after 7 pay commission are at least 1.5 lakhs per month. So you can easily earn good amount of money and make your decent life if you are into academics. Another part is academicians are also appointed on most of the government bodies, and the reports are being sent. There are several governments who are appointing academicians and seeking their reports so as to make the laws. So making of law is also a process in which academicians are involved. So you will always love if you are into research, delivering lectures, getting into the good drafting research reports, and do some kind of teaching. So there is an option for the academics also. Now the last but not the least is the option which at the end of the flag career you can get. If you are a too good lawyer, you can be a party spokesman of any political party. Any political party can hire your services or induct you into the politics, and you can be elevated as a member of parliament or Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha member. So you can be a lawmaker. But for that, dear my friends, you will have to spend huge amount of time. You will have to basically devote your entire life and get yourself into politics. We have seen lawyers virtually rule this country. So every political party have got top 5 lawyers who are ministers in the government. So law making is a process which eventually will have to be done by the lawyers themselves. So politics is also a career option for a successful lawyer after some years. So dear friends, law is the only field which is evergreen, which is dynamic in nature, and which is very lucrative. There are no dearth of opportunities in this field. You can make your life and you can beat anyone. If you have the mettle, please come and join the law field. The opportunities in law field are far more better than any other field. I welcome you to the law field. Thank you so much. All the best.